In the various world religious scriptures. Many people, they have a misconception that Islam is a new religion and it came into existence 1400 years ago. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was the founder of this religion. But in fact, Islam is there since time immemorial, since man set foot on this earth. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he is not the founder of this religion, but he's the last and final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, who was sent for the whole of humanity. Let's discuss Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Jewish and the Christian scriptures. The Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament contains the stories before Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And the New Testament contains the lifetime of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. The Catholics, they believe in 73 books, whereas the Protestants, they have thrown out 7 books as Apocrypha, that is doubtful. And they only believe in 66 books. First, we'll discuss Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Jewish scriptures. It's mentioned the Old Testament. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, Almighty God says, I shall raise them for prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee, and I shall put my words into his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command. Many of the Christians say that this prophecy, it refers to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And when we ask them that how does this prophecy refer to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, so they say, hear the prophecy says, I shall raise them for prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee. The prophet to come should be like Moses, peace be upon him. And the similarities that they give between Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, are that both of them were Jews and both of them were messengers of God. If these two are the only similarities of fulfillment of prophecies, then all the prophets mentioned in the Bible after Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, they fulfill the prophecy. For example, Solomon, Ezekiel, Isaiah, Daniel, Joel, John the Baptist, all of them were Jews and all of them prophets of God. If these two are the only similarities of fulfillment of prophecy, then there are several prophets that are mentioned in the Bible that fulfill the prophecy. Thus, this prophecy does not befit anyone but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If we analyze Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, both of them, they had a mother and they had a father. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he had a mother, whereas he did not have a father. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 45, that he was born miraculously without any male intervention. A similar message is mentioned in the Bible. It is mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 1, verse number 18, and the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 1, verse number 35, that he was born miraculously without any male intervention. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was like Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was unlike Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. Furthermore, if we analyze, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they got married and they had children. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he did not get married, nor did he have children. Furthermore, if we analyze, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they had a natural death. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he did not have a natural death. It is mentioned in the glorious Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 157 and 158, that he was raised up alive. many of the Christians, they argue that he was crucified. If I agree with the Christian, for sake of argument, that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was crucified, irrespective whether he was crucified or raised up alive, he did not die a natural death. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was like Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was unlike Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. Furthermore, if you analyze, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they were worldly kings. They could give punishment of life and death. They had that power. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, it is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 18, verse number 36, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, "My kingdom is not of this world." Furthermore, if you analyze, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they brought a new law. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he did not get a new law. He came to confirm the previous law. It is mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 17 and 18. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, "Think not, I've come to destroy the law or the prophets. I've come not to destroy, but to fulfill." So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was like Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was unlike Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. Furthermore, if you analyze, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they were accepted as prophets by the people as a whole. Whereas Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, it is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 1, verse number 11, that he was not accepted by the people as a whole. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was like Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was unlike Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. Furthermore, it's mentioned in the Old Testament, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, Almighty God says, "I shall raise them a prophet from among thy brethren like unto thee, and I shall put my words into his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command." The next verse, book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 19, it says that whosoever will not hearken unto my words and he shall speak in my name, I will require it of him. Some translations say that I will take revenge. So whosoever does not follow the prophet to come, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Almighty God will take revenge from those people. Further, it is mentioned in the Old Testament, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 29, verse number 12, that a book is revealed to thee, that he is not learned, saying, "Read this, I pray thee." And he said, "I am not learned." And this is exactly what our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ma ana biqari, I am not learned." And this is the fulfillment of the prophecy that is mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 29, verse number 12, it says, "The book is revealed to thee, that he is not learned, saying, 'Read this, I pray thee.'" And he said, "I am not learned." Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he's prophesied in the Old Testament in the Song of Solomons, chapter number 5, verse number 16. It says, "Hikku Muhammad Takim, we kullu Muhammadim, Zahdudi wa Zahrai, Baina Jerusalem. His mouth is most sweet. He's altogether lovely. This is my beloved. This is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem." In Hebrew, im is added as respect. So if to Muhammad, im is added, so it becomes Muhammadim. If to Eloh, im is added, so it becomes Elohim. Let's discuss Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Christian scriptures, in the New Testament. It's mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 157. الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ. Those who follow the unlettered prophet, whom they would find mentioned in their scriptures, in the law and in the gospel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 49, and Surah Saf, chapter number 61, verse number 6. وَرَسُولًا إِلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, and a messenger to the children of Israel. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was only sent for the Bani Israel, only for the Jews. It is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 16. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, "And I shall pray to the Father, and he shall give you another comforter." It is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 15, verse number 26. It is mentioned, "But when the comforter is come, whom I shall send unto you, even the Spirit of truth, which proceeded from the comforter, he shall testify of me." It is mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter shall not come. For if I depart, I shall send him unto you. Now the Comforter, if we analyze, in the original language, it is Paraclete, which means Comforter. And the other word is Parakletos, which means praiseworthy. Irrespective, whether it's Paraclete or Parakletos, both the meanings befit the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Many of the Christians say that this refers to the Holy Spirit. Now, if we analyze the Holy Spirit, he was there before Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born. He was there in the womb of Elizabeth. He was there when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born. He was there in the Feast of Pentecost. He was there when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was baptized. So, this prophecy can surely not refer to the Holy Spirit, but refers to no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. It's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For even the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he hears shall he speak. He shall glorify me. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For even the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he hears shall he speak. He shall glorify me. This prophecy again refers to no one but Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And we know our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spoke whatever was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if the words were put into his mouth. So this prophecy befits no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We Muslims, we believe that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe that he was born miraculously without any male intervention. We believe that he gave life to the dead with God's permission. We believe that he healed those born blind and lepers with God's permission. So, these prophecies, they befit no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. This was in brief regarding Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Christian scriptures. It was the tip of the iceberg. I would like to end my talk with a quotation from the glorious Quran, from Surah Kawthar, chapter number 108, verse number 1 to 3. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. Verily, we have granted thee the abundance. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Then glorify thy Lord and praise him. Inna shani akahu al-abtar. Verily, who hath thee will be cut off from future hope. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
হাদিসে রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ইসলাম কি পাকিজা তালিমাত কা সর চশমা হ্যায়। দুশমনান ইসলাম কা এক গিরোহ ইস পাকিজা চশমে কো গদলা করনা চাহতা হ্যায়। اس باطل گروہ کی نقاب کشائی کے لیے دیکھیے ہمارا پروگرام انکار حدیث ایک باطل تحریک شیخ رضا اللہ عبدالکریم مدنی کے ساتھ صرف پیس ٹی وی اردو پر
اللہم صل علی محمد اللہم بارک علی محمد
جانیے کیا ہوگا ان کا انجام جو کر رہے ہیں قرآن و حدیث کے معاملات میں اپنی ذاتی رائے کو شریک انکار حدیث ایک باطل تحریک ہر بدھ رات 11:30 اور دوبارہ دوپہر 12:30 انڈیا میں پیس ٹی وی اردو پر ڈائیلاگ Discussion, debate, rebuttal, conclusion.
Eliminate misconceptions about religion. Get enlightened.
Witness Dr. Zakir Naik in a battle of words in Crossfire, next on Peace TV.
Yes.
Jazakallah, Brother Farik, for the talk. Respected guests, brothers and sisters, before we disembark from this spectacular journey, let us remind ourselves of the history of Islam and the Prophets. We know that the Prophets were doubted, insulted, threatened, and persecuted, but their trust was sure in Allah. A few examples will help us revive our faith. The great exemplars of virtue conquered evil, each according to his circumstances. Ibrahim alayhi salam embraced falling to death without hesitation, thus stood staunch in the fire of persecution unhurt. Ayyub alayhi salam was an embodiment of patience, humility, and taqwa. It was with these weapons that he fought and conquered evil. Nuh alayhi salam's mission was to a wicked world plunged in sins. His heart bleeds for his people, obstinate as they are. He survives the flood by his faith in the world of unbelief. Dawood alayhi salam was a man of exceptional strength. He sought justice and sang Allah's praises. Ismail alayhi salam was true in constancy amid temptations. In fact, assured the father to fulfill the word to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, an exemplary sacrifice. Sulaiman alayhi salam stands firmly by his principles and by wisdom subdues the refractory. Musa alayhi salam, in his mission, triumphed over arrogant, wronged by his patience and faith. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was an epitome of wisdom and patience. The leader of leaders, in fact, remains the number one hero all times. We learn that evil must perish, despised and disgraced. The lives of the prophets are full of human vicissitudes, painting vivid colors with their spiritual implications, the most varied aspects of their lives. How much we have to learn from these exemplars of wisdom and patience, from these role models of success. The greatest lessons we learn from the life is that we Muslims must do our best in spreading peace in whatever land we live in. Our history is full of examples showing that our ummah rose every time it fell. This time also, we, the dais of the next generation, assure you, take the ummah to the new heights of spirituality and success. Inshallah, with Allah's support and parental support, we not only desire to shine in the name of Islam, but also desire to win the final bliss. Now I call upon Sister Rushda Naik to present the Arabic dua.
اللهم لك الحمد وأنت قلت وقولك الحق المبين قل صدق الله فاتبعوا ملة إبراهيم ومن أصدق من الله حديثا ومن أصدق من الله قيلا لا إله إلا الله المتوحد في الجلال بكمال الجمال تعظيما وتكبيرا المتفرد بتصريف الأمور على التفصيل والإجمال تقديرا وتدبيرا المتعالي بعظمته ومجده الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا وصلوات الله وسلامه على خاتم النبيين وإمام المرسلين الذي أرسله الله هاديا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا ونحن على ما قال ربنا وخالقنا من الشاهدين وبما أوجب وألزم غير جاحدين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله علانيته وسره أهلنا أنت أن تحمد وأهلنا أنت أن تعبد وأنت على كل شيء قدير لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه غير مودع ولا مكافئ ولا مستغنى عنه ربنا تم نورك فهديت فلك الحمد وتم فضلك فرزقت فلك الحمد وتم حلمك فغفرت فلك الحمد اللهم لك الحمد وأنت نور السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد وأنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد وأنت الحق وقولك حق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والنبيون حق ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق وأنت الله الرؤوف الرحيم اللهم لك الحمد على ما أنعمت به علينا من نعمك العظيمة وآلائك الجسيمة حيث أنزلت إلينا خير كتبك وأرسلت إلينا أفضل رسلك وشرعت لنا أعظم شرائع دينك وجعلتنا من خير أمة أخرجت للناس وهديتنا لمعالم دينك الذي ليس به التباس اللهم إنا عبيدك بنو عبيدك بنو إمائك نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا وسابقنا ودليلنا إليك وإلى جناتك جنات النعيم اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا اللهم اجعلنا ممن يقرأ القرآن فيرقى ولا تجعلنا ممن يقرأ القرآن فيشقى اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم لقلوبنا ضياء ولأبصارنا جلاء ولذنوبنا ممحصا وعن النار مخلصا اللهم انفعنا وارفعنا بالقرآن العظيم الذي رفعت مكانه وأيدت سلطانه وبينت برهانه وقلت يا عز من قائل سبحانه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه أحسن كتبك نظاما وأفصحها بيانا وأحكمها حلالا وحراما اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا وسيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين
Jazakallah such the Rujda. I, on behalf of the band of Dais of the next generation, express great appreciation to Dr. Zakir Naik for judging us personally and for giving such a wonderful platform of Peace TV, to which we can not only reach billions but get multiple reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through our school, we are able to connect so beautifully to Islam and marinate in our deen and live it courageously. I thank the great research team of Islamic Research Foundation and the diligent Islamic International School in all walks of life. Alhamdulillah. We make a determined, robust team pioneered by Dr. Zakir Naik. Together, we can move mountains, one rock at a time, with strength, steadfastness, unflinching faith and taqwa, one shovel after the other. With Allah's help, we will move the world.
All people of the world, can we spare a little justice?